Six yes, one no.
Thank you very much.
Sears and Yonkers are both gone, but investors say this won't stop their vision of progress at Merle Hay Mall.
The city was very wise in their negotiations with us, and we have to clear certain hurdles in order to gain access to the funds that they're providing us.
The mall investors will receive $4.8 million in city development grants through the course of 12 years. To keep receiving the money, they must fill this vacated Sears store in the first 4 years. Elizabeth Holland says this isn't just about the big box retailers.
They don't bring something new and different. And while we were very sad to see Yonkers and Sears go, we feel like it's going to give us an opportunity to bring in regional players and a different kind of draw to the shopping center.
Like adding new retailers and more entertainment.
Making Merle Hay both a convenient destination as well as a regional destination.
You want to make sure that the mall is viable for future use, and that's what I'm really pushing hard to make sure that we do.
Des Moines City Manager Scott Sanders says the city has worked with Merle Hay investors in the past and says they're always innovating, like adding Flick's Brewhouse.
It not only benefits the Merle Hay area, the northwest side of Des Moines, it's actually a regional spot for the entire city and the metro area. We've got to make this thing work.
In Des Moines, Adam Brower, KCCI 8 News, Iowa's News Leader.